Good evening, everyone. I'm Rahul. I come from India, and I work in Budapest in the Avis Budget Group Business Support Center. And I'm going to talk about the cash application transformation through automation. Something similar to what my friends from Electrolux has presented. So I won't go into technicalities, but I'm going to talk about things which are important for you from the project standpoint and from the decision making regarding commercial or other elements, and how it will help you to make a decision if you have aspirations to automate your cash processing process. So before I start, I just want to ask you a question. How many of you have rented cars? Or you rent cars? Well, I think you need to start to do that. So Avis Budget Group, it's a leading global service provider for the vehicle rentals. We have our presence in more than 180 countries. We have more than 30,000 employees and 11,000 rental locations. These are our brands, as you can see: Avis, Budget, Zipcar, which is on the car sharing model. It's based on the membership. You have an app. If you're a member, you can rent a car even for 1 hour, 2 hours, wherever the Zipcar model or the practice is available. Payless, which is primarily in the States, but now we are implementing that in Europe as well. Any Italians here? So we have Maggiore, which is a very local Italian brand, which we recently acquired, and Apex, which is from Australia, New Zealand. The reason it's important to understand, you know, our landscape, I'm just gonna spend some time on our processes and brands. Regarding the support center in Budapest, it was founded in 2003. It was a very small shared service center. However, today we are a strong team of more than 1,200 people. We are supporting 5 brands of Avis Budget Group. We serve in 10 different languages. As per the organization goes, the average age is 28, so it's a young organization. Up until 2011, it was a very small shared service center. Just the basic transactional processing was done from the BSE. In 2011, Avis Budget Group US acquired Avis Europe, which was a family business. And you can imagine each and every country had their own IT organization, their own way of work, their own processes, managing directors, policies. So absolutely non-standard. And when the decision was made to centralize the operations for front office and back office in Budapest, we had a huge task in front of us. So we started our journey, you know, in terms of the process landscape, order to cash, record to report, and procurement to pay processes. We started to migrate in the as-is manner to Budapest. And you can imagine when I say as-is manner, we had roughly about 700, 800 applications on which the employees were working because of the variety of brands that we have and the way the processes were done in the countries. Then, once we had migrated these processes in the BSE in Budapest, we started to look at transformation and standardization opportunities. And today, hence, I'm going to spend time on AR cash processing transformation or standardization. To start with, we had a business challenge in front of us. The business challenge was, as my friends from Electrolux also mentioned, we had a MAR level roughly about 9 million, 10 million on account payments. Huge. We had lots of unmatched open legacy invoices. When I say legacy invoices, it was not just 1 or 2 years legacy invoices, 5 years, 6 years. And you can imagine the impact was on the customer. Because when you were doing your dunning process, customers were receiving statements and reminders for the invoices that they had already paid. So it was impacting our customer satisfaction as well. At the same time, our turnaround time for cash processing was quite high. Not just 5 days, it was taking us sometimes 15 days, sometimes months as well, just to reconcile. You know, a lot of back and forth between the customer and the processing team. Of course, we were highly language dependent, and we have high number of FTEs performing the cash processing task. So this was the problem statement in front of us. And we wanted, as our objective, to have a common system and a common standard process. Therefore, we looked at automation. But before we looked at the automation, I would like to highlight the things that we did in-house. when I say in-house, means what are the things, what are the homework that we did before we went for automation. It was really essential for us to look at all the customer segmentation that we had, all the different processes that we had. So we started to map those processes. We started to map all the nuances, all the exceptions. We started to look at, you know, earlier the way the payments were getting processed, it was absolutely having no strategy in place. So we formulated a manual strategy as well. We call it STAR methodology, which means segregating the payment, segregating based on the value, the money of the monies that were coming in, segregating based on the customer importance, you know, top corporates, medium segment, low value customers, and then targeting the payments, applying it, and then reviewing the payments, whether the payments have been applied correctly or not. All these things were not done before. We implemented a daily communication plan, a daily communication between the collectors and the customers to follow up on the on account, asking for remittances, and so on. We looked at standardizing the non-AR, non-account receivables related payments and account receivables related payments and the workflow around it. By doing so, we had basically done nothing but we created a value stream map for all countries, all different processes, how it was done. And then we started to run an RFP to shortlist the vendor. And when we had selected the vendor, in this case, Remilia, and we used their software called as Allocate, it was really easy, or I would say essential, for us to present to the service provider what is our existing process, what are our existing challenges. So they didn't have to spend time on looking at doing a due diligence on our processes, because that would eat up the implementation time as well. So we wanted to shorten that. So all the homework that would be required by any vendor, any supplier, we had already cut short that by doing our homework. Then we started to look at, you know, implementing Allocate. And as a result, where we had 0% cash allocation hit rate, we reached for some countries to 90% as well. I'll talk more in detail on the following slides, how we did that. But not just that, we also looked at automating the bank files, the bank statements onto the system. Because in certain cases, you might be able to automate, you know, how the remittances are getting uploaded and your ERP system is information is getting uploaded. But still, you know, small things like downloading the bank statement and then uploading it to the cash processing system, all those things also we looked at automating it, and we did that. It's very essential in the initial part of the project itself that you involve your treasury department, and that's what we did. Now, as a group, and as I explained a while ago, each and every country had their own banking solution. They were working with local banks. So the treasury, so when we proposed this business case to treasury, they said they are already thinking of having a common banking solution. So we had even put the project on hold till the time we had the common banking solution in place, because we didn't want it to rework. A service provider, or the IT vendor in this case, whether Hensa Orga or Remilia, you know, it's essential for them to understand, not to rework, because we told them we will be in future having Bank of America. So they don't have to work with 10 different bank statements and prepare an algorithm based on that. So we took kind of a conscious decision on putting the project on hold for a couple of months and let the Bank of America solution to be implemented. That reduced my cost of implementation as well. Because if Remilia or Hensa Orga, and Remilia in this case, would have to work with 10 different bank statements, you know, then the cost of implementation would have been higher. That helped us. Also, you know, I mean, at the end of the result was that we implemented a common system, Allocate, and we could sunset, we could make 5 applications redundant. So there was in store for IT as well, not to support those 5 different applications going forward. So the business benefit was not just from the FTEs or cash allocation side or on account side, it was also in terms of for the IT to not spend money on the maintenance of those 5 applications. Just as a result, if you look at the chart here, our auto hit rate from 0% now up until January, I have the results, is at 68% at an MEA level auto hit rate. Now this is how we calculate auto hit rate in Avis Budget Group, is at 2 levels. One, where there is absolutely zero manual intervention. which means whatever comes in gets automatically posted and you don't even know it. It just gets reconciled. And the other way is the system that we have has a cognitive learning in itself. It's a self-learning system. So as the customer payment behaviors are, how they are sending us the remittances, if the algorithm is not defined as per their remittances, the system starts to give us some hints and tips that, you know, it will give us a tip that, okay, system will give you options that this payment can be applied to these invoices, and then you just need to select that. And once it becomes a practice, you can talk to the Remilia guys, and then they will make it as business as usual. And your auto hit rate, fully auto hit rate, will go even higher. So on the following slide, I will tell you how you can really tweak your system as in when you progress. So it's not like a one-time setup and you're done with it. But just as far as the business impact is concerned, I've put some numbers here. You know, a lot of productivity benefit, almost 600,000 euros of P&L impact, on account cash reduced by 60%, turnaround time improved from 5 days to 1 day. But let me just talk about some of the lessons learned here. As I said initially, you know, we had multiple applications. It's really important for us to understand, what do you really want to achieve? What are your business objectives? Is it only about cost reductions? Or is it about a long-term plan that you have? That our long-term plan was that we wanted to introduce a plug-and-play process, a plug-and-play methodology, which means Avis Budget Group regularly, you know, acquires more and more licensees, more and more brands. We want to establish a process where if we are doing more acquisitions, we can simply push their processes into the existing model. So that was our long-term strategy. We made the strategy clear to Remilia in this case, and they worked on that. We are having a volume-based contract with them. So I don't have to change or have an SOW with Remilia and tell them we are acquiring a new company or, you know, a new licensee. Therefore, you know, I want you to do a new development. It's very easy for us now. Secondly, you need to know your incoming data, your banking data, your invoicing data, in order to build an accurate system. You need to on the initial stage itself, the more you invest into the deployment of the system, the better it will be for future. So I deployed all my subject matter experts to work together hand in hand with the designers, with the developers of Remilia. So it was very easy for us to understand how does the system work. We didn't keep all the knowledge with Remilia. The knowledge is still in-house. We are using their system. However, the knowledge still remains with us. This is really important. Tweak the system each day. So while we were implementing the system, we were giving feedback to Remilia every day. What was the error rate? Why the errors are coming? We were having discussions with them, analyzing the hit rate on a weekly basis. This really helped us. And you know, this feedback helped us and this communication helped us to improve our hit rate by weekly and monthly basis. So we were changing the system and algorithm based on the customers. And you know, we are a company which has got more than 60,000 accounts, active accounts. We have a large customer base. Therefore, you can imagine how many nuances, how many different type of remittances, how many different type of everything that we have. So we are having a continuous improvement process where we understand now how to tweak the system, what sort of feedback we need to give to the designers, to the developers, and therefore we are monitoring it very closely. Brand identification is really important for each and every customer. Now here I was asked this question that, Rahul, did you have to do any sort of change management at the customer side? The answer is zero. I didn't go to any customer, I didn't ask them to change anything in their process areas. I didn't ask them to change any of their remittance advices. So my customer was happy, my process became standardized. However, it all boils down to one factor, which means that you have to do your homework. If you do your homework well, if you map your processes well, if you monitor how you are progressing with the system, and just don't leave it on the designers or on the vendor, you can definitely have a very successful AutoCash application system in place. And finally, as I said, UAT, I mean, you need to spend as much time on UAT as possible. Not just going by, you know, like, okay, fine, if it's a 3 weeks UAT and then it's done. We spend a lot of time. I wanted to do a very strong proof of concept. So I picked up one country, we devised a solution, and then we had a longer UAT. which means I wanted to see how the system is working, how we are giving back feedback to Remilia, how they are reacting to this feedback, is it a successful model or not, what is the turnaround time I'm having on my payments, and how we are progressing. So when I moved from this one country to the next, it was very easy. It took me almost 1 year to implement the first country and make it absolutely right. It was UK, and we reached 90% hit rate. And then for the next 10 countries, it took me another 1 year. So you will get your return on investments if you have much more stronger first proof of concept without going for a big bang approach here. And that's pretty much about it, actually. I wanted to share these learnings with you. And now I want to spend some time on some questions if you have. Going to that. Yes, sir.
So this talk runs out.
The whole work session that you mentioned, actually, where you said you spent a lot of time actually to dive into details and so on, what was the scope and how long did it take you to analyze everything?
So for me, the scope was I mapped all my countries because I had different systems. And this is really important for me even to run the RFP. Because if my vendor doesn't understand how many applications they have to work on, where will they get the file feed? How many banks they have to work with? What are the different customer expectations and customer nuances? In this case, if I just give a high level overview in the RFP, any vendor will come and say, you know what, as a first level of implementation, we would like to map your processes. And the time that they will be taking in the due diligence, at the end of the day, I will have to bear that cost. So we have strong SMEs in our organization. And I always say that before you go to any automation, any continuous improvement project, to any outside vendors, you need to first do your homework inside, map your processes at least, know where your processes stand, do kind of a benchmark. And we were doing a benchmark within our countries as well. So Hansa Orga, we were already working with Hansa Orga, which was our best in class process. So Hansa Orga was deployed for our German market. And we were already at 60-70% hit rate. So we knew where we wanted to be, because that was already a proven success story for us. So we started to map all the other processes and compare it with Germany. And then we run this RFP, the group selected the vendor, and then it was easy for us to know where we want to be. So that's how we did. And now, as an outcome, we have a different market in North Americas, and we have a different market in Australia and New Zealand. They are coming to us, and they're asking, can they deploy this solution in their markets? And why not? Definitely. So as a next step, we can actually make this system as a global system. So this homework was really important for us. It takes time. It really took us a lot of time, almost 1.5 years, to come to a level of where we are, what we want to be, then run an RFP. And you know, I'll be very honest with you. I mean, it was all worth at the end of the day. Any other questions? Silence means that you liked my presentation, yeah? Perfect, thank you very much.